Alright, so I'm resuming my Ocarina of Time stream. Yesterday was a marathon session for me. I did the Forest, Fire, and Water Temples. Which means I'll now be heading towards the bottom of the well. Just gotta run over to Kakariko Village for a quick cutscene first. You know what, while I'm here, there's a gold skull Tola I can get that I haven't bothered to get till now. I'm not even going to bother summoning Epona, because by the time I summoned her and climbed on her and rode over here, it would take about the same amount of time. It's just not worth it. And cutscene. Ouch. Well, that's a spoiler. Come on, Sheik. Thank you. Okay. This is an interesting little thing that's in the game that nobody's quite sure exactly what it does. I'm not at the right angle. But if you have the long shot... Well, you can get up there into the windmill. And nobody's quite sure exactly what the purpose of going into the windmill is. It might have been for a boss fight there, with that cutscene we just saw. That was cut. Who can say? There we go. Use it to climb up here. And you can see out. And there seems to be no purpose to this whatsoever. At least no purpose that remains in the game. But I can't actually do anything here, as far as the Shadow Temple goes, without the Lens of Truth, which is actually hidden in the bottom of the well as Young Link, so I will be going back in time. And we'll be playing as Young Link again for a little while. Things as Young Link before I head towards the bottom of the well, so just bear with me. Just things I couldn't do without tools from Adult Link. Or things that I just couldn't be bothered to do the last time I was a child. Did I get this, Skulltula? Apparently I did. Okay. And then back here is, there's a hidden pit that has a gold Skulltula in it. One of the more annoying gold Skulltulas in the game, as it requires you to do quite a bit of backtracking. There's really only, the only reason to come back here again is to get this gold Skulltula. A bug in the game that you can use to get pretty much unlimited gold Skulltula tokens. Target this Skulltula token, release the boomerang, and then backflip right as you release the boomerang, then you'll go into this light portal, and you'll have credit for getting the token, but you will also be able to go back down and find that the Skulltola still exists, and you can use that to get up to 999 gold Skulltola tokens. I'm not a damn dirty cheater, so I'm not going to do that. So this is actually the entrance to the Shadow Temple right here. And they actually did something quite clever here. Is you can't open it without the fire arrows, which only Link can get. Adult Link can get those. So you can use Din's fire to light the majority of the torches, but not all of them. So it basically creates a barrier to young Link being able to get in there. I was just making sure I got the Skulltola that's hanging out up on that wall. I must have gotten it earlier. Now before I head into bottom of the well, there's another minigame I can do with the Ocarina songs I have learned since becoming Adult Link. So I'm going to run over to Zora's domain and do those real quick. So over here is the Musical Frogs. I've already played most of the songs for them, but I haven't played the Song of Time for them yet, or the Song of Storms, because you learn those after it's convenient to come here. You get 50 rupees for each basic song if you play them the Song of Storms. They give you a piece of heart. And once you've played all of the basic songs for them, there should be six. That's Zelda's Lullaby, Epona's Song, Seria's Song, the Sun's Song, Song of Time, and Song of Storms. Then you can play the minigame with them. Now each frog represents a different button on the gamepad, A and the 4C buttons. It's easy easier if you have it written down in advance, which I do in a number of places, but I'd rather do it this way. Makes me feel like I've earned it. Oh, come on. There we go. Okay, now I will head to the bottom of the well. So as Adult Link, if you talk to the Windmill Man, he teaches you the Song of Storms and says that 7 years ago, a little kid played him the song and it messed up the windmill. That little kid is you. So you teach the Song of Storms to the Windmill Man, who teaches it to you, who teaches it to the Windmill Man, and it makes no goddamn sense at all. It's a time loop that has no beginning point, it just goes in circles. That'll drain the well, and now I can get to the next dungeon in the game. Bottom of the well. And this would seem to be a dead end, but the wall isn't real, and you'll be dealing with a lot of that here in the bottom of the well. Gotta watch out for these faceplates, because wherever you see them, there's a pit right underneath them with a fake floor that you'll fall right through. I think, yeah, I don't have a key yet. Ow! can actually make the bottom of the well really painless. You could basically run right in and run right out, because all you really need out of here is the Lens of Truth. And everything else you do in here is just to get Gold Skull Tullas. But since I am going for a 100% playthrough, I will be doing the Gold Skull Tulla stuff too. Ah, dang it. Try not to pay attention to how this floor, if you look on the map there, very closely resembles a body lying on the ground. This whole dungeon's kind of creepy like that. Where's that ladder at? There you are. Walked right by it. Gifters, basically the same thing as Reed-Eds. They're a little bit stronger, but they're just as dumb, so it don't matter too much. Thank you. Oh, come on. I'm gonna make life easier for myself and just go get the freaking Lens of Truth now instead of the kind of dumb way I've been going about things so far. Yeah, good for you. So get grabbed by one of these hands and you'll see the boss. Dead hand. And the same rules apply to every other Young Link boss. Use two sticks, you'll deal way more damage that way. And then he very slowly runs away, let the hand grab you again. And we keep training. Okay, now I have the Lens of Truth, now I can see all the fake stuff and invisible stuff that's all over this dungeon. Including right here behind it is a chest that you can't see without the Lens of Truth. With rupees in it that I don't need, but oh well. Okay. Now you can see all kinds of hidden rooms and alcoves in here. Make life much easier for myself. Actually, once you have the Lens of Truth, you can just leave this dungeon. There's nothing else in here that you, quote-unquote, need to get. But there are a lot of Skulltulas down here. So you do need to stick around long enough to get those, at least. Okay, go to hell. Thank you. I hate you. Come on. Really? The Nintendo 64 joystick has not aged well. Honestly though, that was 50% me, 50% Ocarina of Time does not have a great camera. But with all the years I've been playing this, I should have been able to compensate for it by now, so okay, that was 100% me. Okay, third time's the charm, I'm gonna get through this room this time. Ah, dang it. Yeah, get it back. What? Oh, come on. Take damage. Once again, these FPS drops are not my stream, that is the original console. I am playing on a Nintendo 64. This is what we used to think was good. Yeah. And last gold Skulltola. Okay. So I'm almost ready to return to the future timeline and head for the Shadow Temple. But there's one more thing I want to do before I leave. There's a mini game in town that you can play as Young Link that I always wait till I have the Lens of Truth to play it, because otherwise there's like a 1 in 36 chance that you'll win. Which, you know, that's not great odds, so I always wait till I have the Lens of Truth, that way you can cheat at it. One in 32 chance you'll actually guess all of those successfully. It costs you 10 rupees every time you want to try. Have fun with that. I'll come back with the Lens of Truth. Okay. Now, we will head back to the future timeline and do the Shadow Temple. Now that I have the long shot, I can actually go and get another piece of heart down here. It's the first time you do Dampy's Grave Race. You can't beat him because he's just too fast. But once you have the long shot, you can beat him. And if you beat him, he gives you a piece of heart. Hey! This is one place we're having a real camera rather than just press Z button to lock the camera behind Link would really help. But I'm doing okay, you just gotta keep up with them. Until you reach the last room, then you can, right here. Yeah, I don't think that was quite fast enough. Nope, not quite. Oh, I did it. Great. Awesome, that means there's only 4 more pieces of heart left in the game. Aw, but I wanna. Just let me do it. Now to get into this dungeon, you need Din's fire, and you need the fire arrows. Just stand on this pedestal, cast Din's fire. And that'll open the gate. Oh, I thought you needed the fire arrows too to get in. I'm smoking crack or something, I don't know. Never mind. Oh, that's right, this is how they keep young Link out of the dungeon, is you need the hookshot. Oh. I have a really bad memory, so don't mind me. And you see here, there's actually a puzzle to solve here, but I'm not ready for that yet. What are the quirks of the Shadow Temple is? Yes, thank you, I know. You get the dungeon item really, really early. It's one of the first items you get in here. Actually, it might be the first item you get in here. Dead hand one more time, and you get the Vigoron sword, he's a pushover. Oh, come on, put your head down here and fight me. Alright, fine. I'll just smack you. Hey! So these are the hover boots, which have not appeared in any other Zelda games, which kind of surprises me because you could probably do much more interesting things with them with better technology, but this is the only Zelda game they've ever appeared in. Now that I have the hover boots, I can actually get across this chasm. If you look with the lens of truth, you can see the skull is the only one that's real. Point the bird at the real one. And now we can get through the gate. A Gibdo. My Bigoron sword laughs at a Gibdo. Okay. So I got the compass and the dungeon item, but I still haven't found the map. Like I said, you get items in a really weird order in this dungeon. The silver rupee puzzle. If you're anything like me, by the time you get to end of Ocarina of Time, you will never want to see another silver rupee ever again. Oh, but just wait to come back in Master Quest. There's even more of them. They go quite overboard. I don't think I can do anything down here yet, but I'm gonna double check just to be sure. Yeah. That's just a shortcut you can use later if you feel like leaving the dungeon. And you can clearly hear there's a gold Skulltula there too, but it'll be a while before we get there. Thank you. Whoa. Okay. I got really lucky there. Gotta be careful fighting these Stalfos. There's a little pushback when you impact their shields, so it is possible to knock yourself right off the edge. Are you kidding me? Alright, that's it. Oh, come on. I don't care, I have so many hit points. I do not care if you hit me. Come on. Attack me, jerk. I need a key. Okay, we'll come back. This is interesting. Only one with the Eye of Truth will find the stone umbrella that protects against the rain of blades. This is the stone umbrella. And I gotta tell you, this is not how an umbrella works. Hate to break it to you. If this is how an umbrella works, there would be much less demand for umbrellas. I might have missed the dungeon map, but I'm not too concerned about it. Now that I think about it harder, I think you actually get the dungeon map back in those tomb rooms where you get the hover boots, but oh well. I do not need it, so I'm not gonna worry about it. You want to tell me that it doesn't count for 100% completion if I don't get the dungeon items? Well, you can say that, and you may actually be right. I don't care. Kill the keys. Okay, if you insist. Thank you. I can't even be bothered to take my boots off. Oh, that's quite what I wanted, but okay. Sacred feet should let the wind guide them. Oh yeah, that's right. And there's the chest. That was what I was really after. I already knew about the sacred feet. Oh, whatever. Why are the Shadow Temple and Bottom of the Well full of chests that have worthless junk in them? I don't know. I really don't. And now we're back at the bottom, where that shortcut was at. And with a little help from our scarecrow friend, I can reach the next gold skulltula. I've explained about the scarecrow song in two of my past streams. I'm quite tired of explaining it. If you really want to know, Google it. Thank you. Stop laughing at me and fight. And you want to jump off the ship at this point, because it does crash into the wall and sink, and it can potentially kill you. Which is, you know, not fun. Yep, that's the second room that has had these skulls in it. The second room with the gold skull toes hidden behind the skull. The Shadow Temple is more about atmosphere than originality. Oh, come on, throw the damn thing. I hate you, Link. There we go. Oh, there's no key in here? I thought there was a key. Okay, never mind. Moving on. This is why you don't build your death trap out of wood. Okay. Now we can go towards the dungeon boss, who is memorable, if ridiculous. Hey! Just making sure there wasn't a Skulltola over there. Oh. I'm gonna check anyway, just because I'm being paranoid. There's nothing worse than having to replay a dungeon to see if you missed any Skulltolas in it. And here he is. Memorable but ridiculous. Yeah, from an era when every Nintendo game had to have a boss who was two disembodied hands that you fought separately. Alright. One more heart container, four more heart pieces to go. Another temple cleansed, time to meet the sage, who Sheik has already spoiled the identity of. Way to be a spoil sport, Sheik. Got a busy schedule. now there's just one temple left. And that's the Spirit Temple over in the west end of Hyrule. So we'll be heading there now. Run over here real quick. There's a gold Skulltula in this pit that I have not quite claimed yet. I came here earlier on with Young Link, but I didn't have the tools I needed yet. So I paid a visit to this area when I was doing the Bagoron Sword side quest, but I didn't hang around very long. I didn't solve all the problems in the area, because frankly I just wanted to get in and get out. But now that I have to be here, I will actually take the time to solve the carpenter's problem. Like there should have been something under one of those rocks. Oh well. So the carpenter came to repair the bridge, which you saw I had to leap over with Epona, but all of his junior carpenters have been kidnapped by the Gerudo thieves, so now I'm gonna go rescue them. I'm just gonna get myself seen and thrown in jail, just because it's a little easier if you start off from the jail, I find. So they throw Link in jail, but they let him keep all of his equipment, because They're idiots. I gotta see if I can find my way through here. This place is a bit of a maze. And I think, yeah, I already went the wrong way. I'm talented. Okay. Here's the first carpenter. And fun fact, the carpenters are actually named John, Paul, George, and Ringo. That's right, there's four carpenters, and they are named after the Beatles. Watch out for their spin attack, because it can one-hit kill you. Although if it hits you, it doesn't actually kill you, it just sends you back to jail. But it does make you start over from scratch, which isn't fun. Ichiro the Carpenter. I thought they were named after the Beatles. I read that somewhere. Maybe that's in another translation. You can't trust anything I say. I don't know what I'm talking about. This is actually the last carpenter you're supposed to find, but I'm doing things in kind of a weird order. Because I can never remember where these guys are at, so I just kind of wander around until I find them all. I just remember this is the last one you're supposed to find, because... this one ends on a dead end, and all the other ones have two entrances, have an entrance and an exit. And I know I read somewhere that these guys are named after the Beatles, but it's got to be in another translation of the game. Jumped right into her attack. Okay, now for the last carpenter, who I always have a really hard time finding. Hopefully it won't take me too long. Well, that didn't work. That's okay, it just puts me down here, right where I was at. How do I get to the upper areas? Oh, wait. This might be it right here. Yep, here it is. Thanks, camera. You're awesome. You're a great camera. Last two 3D Zeldas I played were the HD versions of Wind Waker and Twilight Princess, so going back to this Z button based camera is pretty awful. Okay. Oh, are you? Oh, blah, blah. Blah, I say, blah. Okay, third time's a charm. I suck. That's what it is. It's as simple as sucking. And the act of sucking, and sucking less. No, get down. Shut up. Shoot. Okay. Enough sucking from me. Let's do this right this time. There we go. Thank you. Yeah, I gotta tell you, repairing the bridge is not helpful because I'm never gonna use the bridge. But now the Gerudo, so impressed by my sneaking around and shooting them with arrows, are making me an unofficial member. Now I can use everything in the fortress to my heart's content, which is good because they have a few mini games I can play. That right there is the Gerudo training ground where you can get the ice arrows. I'll be going there shortly. But there's some other things I want to grab first. Cannot remember how to get up to the top floor. How do I get up there? There, that's not, I think, how you're supposed to do it, but I'll do it that way. That works. Have a shooting range where you can get the last quiver upgrade and also one of the pieces of heart. And also a gold Skulltola. I meant to do that. Climb on the horsey, please. Thank you. And it's got to be daytime. Of course it does. Okay. Okay, so this is hard. Power kill. And shoot all the pots first for 100 points each. Don't move your joystick at all, just time it. And then for the rest of it, aim for the targets at the front and back of the course. So I got the piece of heart, but I need a higher score to get the quiver upgrade. I think I need 1400 points to get the quiver upgrade. Okay. So that means every arrow but five needs to be a bullseye. Six more bullseyes and I can do it. There are these targets set up here, but I try not to trust them because you have to fire at them from the side, which can mess your aim up. Ugh. But that's the sticky part, is you only get two passes. Okay, not bad, not bad. Four bullseyes out of six arrows. Okay, four bullseyes. gotta wait to get close enough. There we go. Now I'll go do the Gerudo Training Ground and get the Silver Arrows. And the Gerudo Training Ground is kind of a mini dungeon. Doesn't take terribly long to do. The thing with the Gerudo Training Ground is you've got to be careful how you use your keys, and we'll get to that when we get to that. But for right now, suffice to say, you don't want to just use your keys as soon as you get them. You want to get as many as you can, and then when we get to the treasure room, I'll explain the rest. So this is basically the training ground. As every room has a little challenge in it, you finish the challenge and you get a small key. Here's the silver rupee puzzle. Oh, come on. There's no key in this room, at least from what I can remember. Oh, bite me. Now, if you were to mess up with your keys, you would have to come back after finishing the Spirit Temple. Come back to this room, and then you could shove this block aside and get the keys that you need to finish the dungeon. But I'm not anticipating that being a problem for me, because I remembered the order to do things in.
Hey!
Okay, which way did I go? I think this way. Yep. Cross the Sea of Fire. Life a little bit easier finishing this room. And you can actually go up those blocks and get to a back entrance into the treasure room. Unfortunately, it's a back entrance to the wrong side of the treasure room, so it doesn't help you much. It gets you to the half of the treasure room that has the stuff in it you don't care about. Because really the only reason to do this place is to get the ice arrows, which honestly I never use them. Majora's Mask, they gave the reason for the ice arrows to exist. In Ocarina of Time, the ice arrows have no reason to exist, except to get them for 100% completion. No, I don't think so. Open your mouth and die. Thank you. Detection on these rupees not working real well right now. Oh, come on. What the fuck? I'm getting irritated. Hey, that one actually worked. There is something seriously messed up with that rupee. Now we're back in the first room. And you go into the treasure room, and you make sure you go left here, because if you go right, you will run out of keys. Go left. And midway along here, there's a hidden room. Did I pass it already? I might have passed it already. Yeah, there it is, right there. Another key. And if I did all the puzzles, I should have just enough keys to get the ice arrows. Thank you. And one. Perfect. And everything that's in the right side of the treasure room is worthless. Just, you know, arrows and rupees and stuff. Who cares? Okay. And now we'll cross the Gerudo Desert. Not haunted, but it is a wasteland. Just follow the flags. And here you'll find this little building. I'm not quite sure what it is, really. Out the lens of truth. Thank you. And here we go, the Desert Colossus. Start by running over here. Drop a bomb by this crack. And it's another fairy fountain. And here we go, that's Nairu's Love, the last magic spell in the game. It makes you invulnerable for a short period of time. It can be useful for going berserker on enemies if you're just not very good at the game, but I almost never use it. But if you're rushing through the game and you don't have as many heart containers as I do, you could probably find some useful for it. You stand here and play the Song of Storms. You'll restore this oasis. And it becomes a pretty handy fairy fountain. And then on one of the trees around here, there's a Skulltola. There it is. Care about that knobby. There you go. I can't move. Uh-oh. That's not good. I missed a piece of heart somewhere. So anyway, I go inside the Spirit Temple, and you can't actually do anything in here yet, so I'm just gonna leave right away. And now we'll meet Sheik. Okay, so to do anything in the Spirit Temple, I'm going to have to first visit it as Young Link. Which is kind of the cool thing about the Spirit Temple, is you do half of it as Young Link and you do half of it as Adult Link. I have one fewer heart pieces than I should at this point, but I think I remember where the one I missed is. It's out in Hyrule Field. I'll go get it later. I'm not that fussed about it. So normally Young Link has a hard time getting to the Spirit Temple because the Gerudo won't let him pass the bridge. But I can just teleport straight there now. We have the last patch of Soft Earth in the game, so I can finally get rid of also my bottled bugs and my last magic bean. I'm gonna have to come back here with Adult Link anyway, so I'll just deal with that later. Let's do the Spirit Temple. And here's Nibiru, who is, we have been told, is Ganondorf's second in command. So she doesn't like Ganondorf. So something happened in those 7 years where she went from not liking Ganondorf to being his second in command. What happened to her? Well, we'll find out. The "I'll do something great for you" line has been subject to many jokes, because what exactly she's going to do for you that's so great is never really revealed. It's implied to be a kiss, but, well, you know, the internet being one of those, they've gone to much darker places. I'm not ready to be there yet. Ah! now you get to fight Stolfos with Young Link. Yay. Come on. That works. That doesn't work. Oh. Oh. I hit that switch. I do not remember. Just like that. I need to kill this mummy thing, and the only thing that works against them is fire. You can either lure it into that fire trap, or I prefer the brute force method. Costs more magic, but this game gives you more magic than you can really ever use, so may as well just use Din's fire. And here it is, the one and only time in the game where you actually need bomb juice. Stop! And here it is, the one and only time in the game where you actually need bomb juice. I don't know, maybe you can use a standard bomb to get that, but I think the game even gives you bomb chews, so I think you're intended to use bomb chews to open that. Yeah, that's nice. Oh, there it is. Yeah, bomb chews. There we go. So if you've managed to come this far in the game and still not have gotten any bomb chews, well, that's where you get them. Dumb camera. Pick a direction. Okay, now we're getting to the end of the Young Link portion of the Spirit Temple. Young Link's part of the temple, sadly, isn't that long. I would really like to see a much longer Ocarina of Time dungeon that used both the young and adult Link versions of Link. Both the Shadow Temple and the Spirit Temple kind of explore that idea, but neither of them go very far with it. Kind of disappointing. Get out of the way! first one must have gone out. Okay, come on. Stop being clumsy. Yeah, I know. You're in the way. Thank you. There we go. Now I can reach the silver gauntlets for Nibiru. Okay, so this is an Iron Knuckle. This is as close as Young Link gets to a boss fight in the Spirit Temple. This would be a point where I could totally understand you just turning on Nairu's love and then just not even worry about getting hit, but I'm going to show you a more impressive way to fight this. Ooh. I messed up. Just backflip. Jump attack. Jump attack, backflip, jump attack, backflip, jump attack, jump attack, backflip, jump attack, backflip, jump attack, hey, nice and simple. Here you get the silver gauntlets, and you finish with Young Link's version of the Spirit Temple. No, not remotely. And now we'll find out what happened in Nibiru. Kidnapped and had black magic used on her. Well, magic does everything else in this game, why not? There's the next piece of heart. But now it is time to become Adult Link again, because now Adult Link can actually get inside the Spirit Temple. Past the first room, anyway. Thank you. Is that magic bean I planted will be blooming now? And I can use it to get a gold skull tulla and a piece of heart. Here's the skull tulla. And then just ride it round a little bit further on the loop, and I can get the piece of heart. Just one more piece of heart in the game. I'm pretty sure I know where it's at. I'll get it after the Spirit Temple. So now that I have the silver gauntlets, I can push this aside and gain access to the east wing of the dungeon, which is where Adult Link does most of his adventuring. Should be the compass. Thank you. And now a classic spinning gears to solve light puzzles. Quite cold. I'm sorry. That's my one pun for the night, I promise. I did things in kind of a bad order here, but that's okay. I can fix it. There we go. Chest here. One thing that the 3DS ports, or remakes if you want to call them that, versions of Ocarina of Time and Majora's Mask did that I really liked was it gave it a dedicated Ocarina button. Because I like to keep my ocarina on my C buttons at all times, even if I'm not actually using it in the near future. So pretty much that leaves me with only two C buttons to really use instead of three. So I appreciated the 3DS versions kind of fixed that, kind of made me realize, oh, I'm not the only person that does that. That's just an elevator back to the entrance, in case I have to restart the dungeon from scratch, in case like my game freezes or power outage or anything like that, I can just use that to skip back to this point in the dungeon. Hey. There it is. I'm confused. How'd that chest appear? I didn't... What'd I do to make that chest appear? It wasn't there before. Oh well. And more of the mummies, but they're quite easy now that I have fire arrows. Haha, awesome. Okay, so that did a thing. This is a fun puzzle. Touch him, and yeah, stand on that switch for me. Thank you. And this is another dark net. But I have a Bagoron sword now, so I have nothing to fear. Now I get the other dungeon item in the Spirit Temple. The Mirror Shield. I like the Mirror Shield in Ocarina of Time because it actually does something. The Mirror Shield did appear in A Link to the Past, but was basically worthless. It had a function, but its function was not particularly useful, so he never used it. But as you will see shortly, you actually use the mirror shield for things. Okay, now look at this room. This room you think would be a nightmare, right? Well, you can cheat. I don't think you were intended to be able to do that, but you can do that. And I strongly recommend you to do that, because this room can be a pain in the ass otherwise. I did not mean to do that. What? You can really tell in the Spirit Temple they were running out of ideas and puzzles when playing Zelda's Lullaby in a Triforce, which you've been doing throughout the entire game, is literally the entire puzzle in a room. That's the whole puzzle. Behind the last one I look behind. And boss key. Down we go. Does this room look familiar? It should. That is some powerful sunlight. Long shut yourself into here, and here's the boss door. Oops. There we go. Okay, this is a big iron knuckle, but the fight works exactly the same way. Whoops. Bad timing. Oh, yes, yes. Slow. And it's Nobu. Don't worry, she'll be fine. Now we'll go fight the real boss of the dungeon. Which is Kouma and Kotake. Twin Rover, alright. This fight is cool. I just gotta get them both into frame, which is not always easy. And then reflect the magic of one into the other. Come on, ladies, pick a side. Oh yeah, you don't want to Z-target them. It just makes life harder for you. Okay, that totally went into her, but whatever. Whoa, that was fast. Okay, now phase two starts. This one you need to absorb three types of magic in a row, so three fires in a row or three ice in a row. She makes it easy for you at the start because she always does the same three types in a row, but later on she'll start mixing things up. And unleash it. Switch to the hover boots. halfway across, jump attack, then thrash her with the Boron Sword, and run back out, and repeat. You gotta watch which wand she waves at you, because that determines what type of magic she's gonna throw. You put a good amount of distance between you and her, so that would be... Oops. Well, I screwed that up. I pulled my sword out too soon. Put a good amount of distance between you and her, that way you have time to dodge, attack, she might throw at you, if it's a type you don't want to absorb. Oh, there's the fire I wanted to avoid. Okay, that went right into my shield. Whatever. There we go. Bye-bye. Why they went for a comedy routine on that boss, I don't know, but they did. And now the last temple cleansed, the last spirit awakened, who is, of course, Naburu. Ha ha ha. You see why people make jokes about the promise she made. It's got so much pedo written on it. Okay, so now I need to go back to the Temple of Time for the game's last big plot twist. And even though I teleport back to the Temple of Time, I'm walking through the door here. It doesn't have to make sense, it's a cutscene. And if you somehow don't know the plot twist, here it is. The light of justice will smite all evil. Kind of a good decision on their part to not actually show Ganondorf in that scene. It makes his reveal later on much more impactful. Okay. So I'm not going to go do Ganondorf's castle just yet. I have, 7 gold skulltulls I'm missing and a piece of heart, so I'm gonna go get those first. And I've got about 40 minutes left in this stream, so hopefully I'll be able to get all those in that time. Okay, so the piece of heart I'm missing is in Hyrule Field. In a secret cave, I think, underneath that rock. That's a fairy fountain. By this tree, this random tree. This is why people hate Hyrule Field. There we go. Just need those 7 skulltulas. Haunted Wasteland done? Yes. Ooh, I'm missing some in Gerudo Valley. And Lake Hylia, oh my. But I'm right by Lon Lon Ranch, so we'll head there first. Be a child to get those. Okay. So we'll head to Gerudo Valley. I have a feeling all the ones I'm missing are going to be Child Link. So let's just head back to childhood. Because there were a lot of Child Link's Gold Skull Tullas I skipped. Just straight up skipped them because you need the boomerang to get them. And I didn't feel like walking all the way back over the entire world to reach them. I said I'll come back at the end of the game and get them then. That's exactly what I'm going to do. Oh, I'm still missing one in Lon Lon Ranch, really? Oh yeah, there's another one here. On a wall, high up. That you also need the boomerang to reach. Oh! There it is. Five more to go. Now Lon Lon Ranch is done. Okay, Zora's Domain, I already know where that one is, because you need the silver gauntlets to get that one. This one should be on the back of the lab. Again, only reachable with the boomerang, which is why I did not get it, because when I was here as Young Link, I did not have the boomerang. I did not feel like backtracking to get it. Oh, screw you. Okay, and now the next one. Lake Kylie is done, great. Off to Gerudo Valley. Gerudo Valley's done, Lake Hylia, Market, Hyrule Field, Death Mountain, Kakariko Village. Okay, off to Kakariko. Just three more, and I think I know where all three are at. Excellent. Thank you. Yeah, I got that one. I know, because I've double-checked that one many times. Oh, I got that one. Shoot, that was one of the ones I was thinking I missed. Uh-oh. Okay. Okay, there's two I know for sure that I'm missing. And one of them, I don't know where it is. And if it's in a dungeon, then I'm in a lot of trouble, because it could be in any dungeon, and I would have to replay them all to find it. Oh, I really hope I don't have to do that. The only other place I can think to look is Zora's Domain. There's one there I'm not 100% sure I got, so I'm gonna double check it. It was one of the roll into the trees to find it ones, and I'm awful at remembering to do those. I have a pretty strong feeling I didn't get this one, though. Back by Jabu Jabu. And unfortunately, there's no quick way to get to Jabu Jabu, you just gotta walk back there. Okay, in this tree, I think I missed this one. Yes, I did. Excellent. Okay, the next two are both Adult Link Gold Skull Tallows. Thank you. One of them is in Kakariko Village, and the other one is back in Zora's domain, unfortunately, so I'm going to have to walk back there again. Okay, and then the last one is in Zora's domain, and it's very well hidden. If you're getting all the Skulltolas as soon as they become available to you, this is actually the very last Skulltola you can get in the overworld. Because you can't get them until you got the Silver Gauntlets, which I only got the Silver Gauntlets less than an hour ago. I gotta walk all the way back to Jabu Jabu's little altar again. So back here by the entrance to the fairy fountain, there is a rock which you can't move with bombs or with the Megaton Hammer. But you can move it with the Silver Gauntlets. Pick it up, toss it aside, drop through the hole, and the Skulltola is... Please drop through the hole. And the Skulltola is at the end of a path down here. Except it's probably not going to be because it's not nighttime, but I've come this far, so I'm just going to check it out. I'm tired. Leave me alone. Yeah. Okay. All right, once more with feeling. Oh, they even regenerated the rock for me. How nice of them. And there it is, Gold Skulltula number 100. Yeah, alright. Now let's go get the reward for it. Even though it's not really a reward, but I don't consider the side quest finished till I've gone and talked to the Skulltula guy. Rupees, yay. Actually, the real reward is you can keep talking to him and he'll give you as many of those as you want. Which is still worthless because by the time you've gotten 100 gold Skulltulas, there's nothing left to buy. So the Skulltula quest, the reward for getting 100 is infamous and widely mocked. So all I have left to do now is do the last dungeon and beat Ganondorf, and I'm going to do that tomorrow night. So thank you for watching.